Hello, my name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects. We're in Adobe Premiere Pro and we're going to be taking a look at some of the new builder effects that are available in Sapphire 2022.5. I'm starting with an almost blank sequence. The only thing it's got in there is a 10 second black video clip. And let's make something a little bit more interesting than this. So I'm going to come over to my effect and I'm going to type in S underscore for Sapphire and we're going to go effect. And this is going to bring up the Sapphire Builder S effect. Let's bring that onto a clip and just looking at it, it does, well, nothing. And that's because S effect is a great way to build up more complex effects and presets. So it starts off with a completely blank canvas. Now that's always a bit intimidating to me, so I'm going to come in and I'm going to load up a preset. Now we have almost 300 builder presets already installed in Sapphire now. So I'm going to filter these even further. I can add a filter and I can filter with properties such as, you know, if something's animated or if it's a background, or if I come down to the bottom, we can also filter through version numbers. Starting with version 2020.5, all our presets are now versioned. Let's get rid of 2020.5 and have a look at the new ones in 2022.5. And we have a lovely crop of new animated backgrounds. If I hit play, we can see these playing back. Take a little look at these. Yeah, lovely. And I want to show you how easy it is to start to come in and customize these up. So we'll start with actually liquid metal diamonds. This is one by John Dickinson. I really like this one. And I'm going to hit load. That's going to take us back into the Premiere interface. I'll hit play on this. If it struggles to play back at full resolution, I can easily just drop this down to half or quarter res. And because I'm not really looking at this in a giant window, this sort of quality shift is still going to be pretty tolerable. Now, when we're looking at builder effects, the person who authored the preset has control over which parameters are exposed in the host. Now, some OFX hosts handle this a little bit differently, but if we're working with Adobe, either Premiere or After Effects, then this is going to work identically. And these are the parameters that John thought were most important when he was making the preset up. So it's going to be things like being able to quickly change up the color. Something there, we add a little bit of a green tint, and maybe instead of something hot we go to magenta instead and take this a little bit pink. It's a little bit more alien, and we still got one more color chip which is in ultra glow. There we go, lovely. So easily change things up there, and I'm sure if I move things around like the angle there, we can start to play around with how our diamonds look. So already starting to feel a little bit different here. Now we can go further in and start to work with this effect even more. So if I go edit effect, we can take a look at how these are built up. If I right click, I can move through. So you can see it's quite a complex little effect built up of multiple different filters. And something I find really interesting about this particular effect is the way that John's laid these out for the different sorts of textures we can have in here. So we've got, you know, texture plasma, which is driving the look, but maybe one of these is going to work out better. So if I right click with the mouse and go disable texture plasma and maybe turn on texture spots instead, that gives us a slightly different look. Let's turn off the texture spots, maybe turn texture folded on. We can see we're getting, I'll zoom in a little bit on the viewer. We can see we're getting a different look here as well. And with any of these, we can start to come up and change those parameters. Straight for us there. So there's a huge amount of flexibility in this. Now I said earlier that the author can expose what parameters they think are important within the host. And we do this by coming over to our selection parameters and just turning on a little tick in the box here. And when I take this back out to Premiere, I'm going to have my frequency in the texture cells available to me to work with directly there. Another thing I could do is I can add in another effect. So if I wanted to maybe transform this up a little bit, I'd go to warp transform, just put that in there, and maybe I'll just tilt this a little bit, swivel it up, rotate it around, and let's wrap this by reflections. There we go. And that's giving us a different look again there. If you add in a lot of nodes with a lot of parameters, what you'll notice at some point is we get a little warning sign up here. And this means we can't add in any more nodes into the Premiere interface. So if I thought that warp transform was more useful than maybe bokeh lights, I can turn off bokeh lights, come back into warp transform, and that triangle has gone away. So I can now turn on the parameters that I think are useful for me. So things like shift X and Y and the Z distance. Similarly, if we didn't want to see any of embossed distort back in Premiere as well, we can just turn all of those off now. So we can simplify these up as much as we want to and keep sort of customizing these. So if I hit OK now, we'll see the updated look. If we look over into the effect controls, I'll see the updated parameters as well. So I can now keyframe my shift and my Z distance. And maybe let's just take this way, just kind of do a pan over or something. Play a few frames of that to see if it's something that we want. Yep, that's looking pretty good. So what I'll do is then I'll just render that out and we can take a look at the final result. And there's our final custom effect. Lovely. And that's essentially how we can start to customize background presets in Sapphire 2022.5. We can find the starting point we want simply within the builder presets. We know what the author wants us to look at when we're looking at the host parameter controls, but we can always go deeper inside and edit that effect to come in and customize it and make it absolutely our own. And I really encourage you to have a look and explore some of those builder presets, because just a couple of little changes can make a huge difference to how things look. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I will see you again in another Sapphire tutorial very soon. Thanks for watching. To learn more about Sapphire or any of the Boris Effects products, head on over to boriseffects.com, where you can find hours of free training and free trial versions of all of the software. And if you want to be one of the first to watch the new tutorials, remember to hit that subscribe button.